Okay, so the topic that we are going to read today is a wall box. So what is a wall box? So let me say you about myself. I'm Dr. Tehnia Shahana. I'm a botany lecturer in a tribal welfare college, Nizamabad. So the topic that we are going to read today is a wall box. So what is a wall box, girls? A wall box is an algae. The common name for the wall box is a rolling algae. So let us see the systematic position of the wall box. The wall box belongs to a division Thallophyta. It belongs to class Chlorophyce. It belongs to order Volvocales. It belongs to family Volvocaceae, and the genus is wall box. So this is the systematic position of the algae wall box. Now, wall box belongs to a class Chlorophyce. All the algae which belongs to a class Chlorophyce are green in color because they consisting of the chlorophyll A and the chlorophyll B in themselves. They consisting of a very small amount of the xanthophyll and the carotenoid in themselves. Okay, now, so this is about the systematic position. Now, let us understand about the wall box. A wall box is a freshwater algae. It is in the form of a colony or the synobium. Okay, the wall box is a freshwater algae, and the complete thallus is in the form of a colony or it is in the form of a synobium. These species live in lakes, ponds, streams, ditches, and also in the stagnant water. Okay, now the plant body is multicellular in the form of a colony. Colony may be globular or oval in shape. Definite number of cells are arranged in a specific manner in a colony. And that colony, which is consisting of a definite number of cells, that colony is considered to be as a synobium. Now, in this picture, you can see the picture here, you can see this is of a synobium, girls. Okay, now. Okay, so this is of a synobium. Now, the number of the cells are 100. Number of the cells, I said you the definite number of the cells are present. Okay, so the number of the cells may vary. It may vary from the 1000 to 30,000 depending upon the species of the genus. Okay, now the whole colony is surrounded by a frim envelope of a mucilage, and the inner side is hollow, and the center of the colony contains a mucilage. Okay, the inner side of the colony is completely hollow, and the complete colony, the whole colony is surrounded by means of a mucilage. Each colony contains small flagellated cells and non-flagellated large cells. Okay, now the large cells are called as a gonidium. The cells, gonidium cells, they are involved in the reproduction. Alright, the gonidial cells, they are involved in the reproduction. Now, each cell in the colony, each vegetative cell in the colony of the wall box is similar to that of a Chlamydomonas species. Each cell is uninucleated. You can see in this picture, it is uninucleated and has a cup-shaped chloroplast with a single pyrenoid. Anterior side of each cell consisting of an eye spot, two contractile vacuoles, and two equal size of flagella. Flagellas are acronymatic type. In synobial cells, all the cells are connected to each other by means of the plasmodesmata. Okay, one cell is connected to the another cells by means of a connections, and that connections is considered to be as a plasmodesmata. In the early stage of the synobium, all the cells are similar. It means all the cells are vegetative in phase, in vegetative stage. As the cynobium become matures, they exhibit the division of the labor. The posterior cells lose their flagella and transform into a large reproductive cells. And those cells which has become mature and they develop in the size when compared to that of the vegetative cells, those cells are now considered to be as a gonidia. And it is only gonidia which participate in the reproduction. Whereas the remaining cells, the vegetative cells, they will not participate in the reproduction. Gonidia at cynobium at mature exhibit polarity. Okay, now let us see the reproduction. Reproduction in Wallbox, there are two types of the reproduction. The first one is an asexual type of the reproduction. The second one is a sexual type of the reproduction. So let us see the asexual type of the reproduction. In asexual type of reproduction, three important stages are there. First one is a gonidium formation. Okay. Next is a placer stage. Okay. Next is an inversion. Okay. So let us see the complete asexual reproduction now. Okay. So asexual reproduction occurs during the favorable conditions. During the favorable conditions, it means when the seasons are favorable to the wallbox, then only asexual reproduction will take place. What happened during the asexual reproduction? Posterior cells of the cynobium, they lose the flagella and forms a reproductive cell. Okay. These cells are called as a gonidia. Gonidia are larger in cells. In the first picture, girls, in this first picture, you can say there are a series of the vegetative cells. Out of the series of the vegetative cells, a few one, they loses their flagella and they developed in the size. And they are larger than the remaining vegetative cells. These larger cells are called as a gonidium. Gonidium. Now what will happen? This gonidia will undergo the divisions. Okay. Gonidia will divide. Like from one, they are having two here. Now this keep on dividing from 2 to 4. From 4 to 8. Okay. The picture number C, you can see the 8 stage. This 8 stage is considered to be as a placer stage. I repeat again what is happening. Gonidia divides many times and forms the daughter colonies or the otto colonies. Okay. The first division is parallel to the longitudinal axis of the gonidium, but at the right angle to the surface of the gonidium. It means first one division is transverse and another division is a right angle. Somehow they are forming the four cells, and from the four cells they are forming 8 cells by multiple divisions. Now, this stage in which the 8 cells are present, this stage is considered to be as a placer stage. Okay, what is it? It is a placer stage. The 4 cells which are not in contact with the base begin to migrate towards an upper board, upper side, so as to form the 2 types of cells with an external small pore. And that pore is called as the filio. Okay. Now, 8 cells are formed. The cells are arranged in such a way that they leave a small opening towards an anterior side. And that small opening here is considered to be as a filiopore. Okay. You can see here. It is considered to be as what? Filiopore. Now, what happens after the formation of the filiopore? The filiopore will become widened. The filiopore will become lobed. And the lobes fold back. The lobes fold back and undergoes this daughter colony. Now this undergoes an inversion. Okay. It's undergoes an inversion. What happened in the inversion? All the cells which are towards the lower side will move towards an upper side, and the cells which are towards an upper side will move towards the lower side. Okay, this happens during an inversion. Okay. Now what happens next? Now when the inversion is formed, the complete colony is now inverted. The complete colony is got what? Now inverted. Is inverted. Once the mother synovium is broken, when this synovium is broken, the autocolonies are released out. The synovium, when it is broken, the autocolonies is completely released out. Okay, Ramma? So this is how the asexual reproduction is formed. Next is the type of the sexual reproduction. Generally, the sexual reproduction in case of the Wallbox is a oogamy type. Oogamous type of the reproduction is same in case of a Wallbox. Okay. Now see here. What is happening? Sexual reproduction in Wallbox is oogamy. As I knew this already. So what happened next? Many species are dioecious. In Wallbox, many of the species are dioecious. Dioecious species, like for example, the Wallbox aureus or Wallbox rosellidi, these two are the dioecious species, okay? But few species are monoecious. Like for example, the Wallbox globator, Wallbox capensis, these two species are monoecious. Monoecious species are protandrous type. What are they? They are the protandrous type. Now, the asexual reproduction is controlled by hormones generally produced by the male gametes. Here, the sexual reproduction is controlled generally by means of a male gametes. The female and the male gametes are developed from the gonadium. Now, we know, girls, how the gonadia is formed. Of the many here, in this picture, you can see there is a line of vegetative cells. Of these vegetative cells, few of the cells will increase in the size. Okay, these cells are increasing in the size. They loses the flagella. They increase in the size, they loses the flagella. And these cells, now it is considered to be as a gonadia. Okay, now in sexual reproduction, there are two types of the gametes. That is the male gametangia and the female gametangia. The male gametangia is considered to be as an androgonium, or it is considered to be as an antridium in simple terms. And the female gametangium is considered to be as an oogonium. So, what is happening? What is happening here? First, we will see the formation of an antridium. Okay. In the posterior part of a synovium, a big vesicle cells turn into a male gametangia and the antridium. Okay. The development of the antridium is very much similar to that of an asexual reproduction. In this also, the filiofore formation takes place. In this also, what inversion will take place. Okay. It is very, very similar to that of the asexual reproduction only. Now, we will see again. In the posterior part of the gonadium, the big vesicle cells turn into a male gametangium, which is an antridium. The cells in the antridia divide to form 16 to 512 cells. How many? 16 to 512 cells. Like asexual reproduction, the plaque stage formation takes place, inversion will take place, and somehow the anthrozoids are formed. The cells, the anthrozoid cells, they don't have the flagella on the anterior side. Okay. Now, this is how the spermatozoids, or I can say the antridium development, has taken place. Now, we will see the female gametangium, that is the development of the oogonium. How the development of the oogonium has taken place? Again, of the many vegetative cells, the few cells will increase in size, they loses the flagellum. The female gametangium or oogonium arises in the posterior half of the colony. The how is the oogonium? You can see in this picture. How is the oogonium? The oogonium are globules. They are globules with a peak and is covered by a mucilage layer. Okay, they are globules with a peak and is covered by a mucilage layer. Oogonium is non-motile. This is very important point. It is non-motile. It means it does not have the locomotion. It cannot move from its place. Now, Pogonium is non-motile. Again, it consisting of a small beak-like structure at its anterior side. Now, what happen? Our sperms will enter into the oogonium or the female gametangium by means of this beak here in the picture you can see the oogonium is present. It is surrounded by many anthrozoids. Okay, it is surrounded by the many anthrozoids. Now what will happen? These anthrozoids will get entry into the oogonium by the beak-like structure. Okay, now what happens when they get entry into the oogonium? The fertilization will take place. That is, the fusion of the egg and the anthrozoids will take place, and it result in the formation of the oospore, or it is also considered to be as a zygote. So in the picture D, we can see this one is a zygote state. This one is a zygote. Now, the zygote, what is the color of the zygote? The zygote is reddish in color. Okay, it is reddish in color. After the decay of the colony, the zoospore are set in the resting stage. Whenever the favorable condition will come, they will start undergoing the germination. But until the favorable condition will not come, they will undergo the resting stage. So this is all about the sexual reproduction. So from the sexual reproduction, we got the zygote. Now what is happening in the zygote? When the zygote is under the unfavorable condition, it will undergo the resting stage. But when the zygote is in the favorable condition, the germination of the zygote begins. And what will happen? In the favorable condition, the zygote divides mitotically. So this is zygote girls. It divides mitotically to form the four cells. Okay, it divides mitotically to form the four cells. From this four, the three cells will degenerate. Okay, from four, how many cells? From four, the three cells will degenerate. The three cells will, what will happen? They will get degenerate. Okay, from the four, the three cells will degenerate and the other cell forms a zoospore. A three will degenerate and the other one cell, it will form the zoospore. After the zoospore wall breaks, the zoospore is released. Okay. In the zoospore, the cell division will take place, inversion of the cells will take place, and it leads to a formation of a new synovium. Okay, it leads to a formation of a new synovium. In this also, the inversion, when the zygote undergoes a multiplication, in this also the inversion will take place, like how the inversion has taken place in case of a sexual reproduction or in case of a formation of an anthrozoids. Okay girls, this is how from the zygote we are going to get a new colony by means of a sexual reproduction. Now we will see about the life cycle, girls. What type of the life cycle is present in case of the Wallbox? In Wallbox, the life cycle is an haplontic type of life cycle. What is it? The Wallbox is haploid and is a gametophyte. Okay, the Wallbox is a haploid and is a gametophyte. The gametes released fuse to form the zygote. The zygote is in resting phase. During the germination of the zygote, meiosis leads to haploid cells. Okay, fertilization has taken place. The zygote formation has taken place. During the zygote formation, I said you that the meiosis will take place and the four cells are formed. Out of the four cells, three will degenerate. Okay, I said you this already. So what is happening? The cells, all these four cells, they have formed as a result of the meiosis. So now all the cells are the haploid cells. Okay, there are the haploid cells. Now this is how the life cycle has haploid stage dominant. Okay, are you getting my point? This is how the complete life cycle has a haploid stage dominant. So that is why it is considered to be as an haplontic life cycle. The Wallbox has a haplontic type of the life cycle. Okay, now girls, now here you can see the life cycle. Wallbox, two types of reproduction, asexual reproduction, sexual reproduction. In Wallbox, in case of an asexual reproduction, first the gonadia cells are formed. We know that how the gonadial cells are formed. out of the many vegetative cells, few will increase in size and loses the flagella, and this is how the gonadial cells will form, and that result in the formation of a daughter colonies. And from this is how the sexual reproduction takes place. Now during the sexual reproduction, again the sexual reproduction, two sex organs are present, that is the male gametangia and the female gametangia. The male gametangia gives rise to the spermatozoid, and the female gametangia gives rise to a egg. Okay, it gives rise to an egg. Okay, again what happened? From the spermatozoid's egg, the fusion will take place. It result in the formation of a zygote. The zygote undergoes a reductive division, resulting in the formation of the zygospore, and it result in the formation of a new synovium. So this is how the asexual reproduction takes place in case of a wallbox. So this is the end of the wallbox, girls. So what we have done today, we have studied completely about the wallbox. So you can take, okay, so this is all about the wallbox, girls. So you can take the notes for it if you want. So just take a screenshots of the slides. Okay, girls, please take the screenshots of the slides. All right, girls, do you have any doubts, girls?